I can't see that far in my bifocals. Okay. Can you hear me at all?
Let's try the other mic.
Check. No better? Is this better in the back? Mr. Wolf, where are you?
How about if I yell really, really, really loud? Okay. Mr. Limerick, can you text him? Tell him to get up here, please.
Somebody go turn on my game.
Okay. I'll be back.
Thank you.
like to start on something different that I think I used to do before COVID, but I forgot the last couple of years because we had 2 years without COVID, and that is talk about. Still hear me? Okay. I'm trying to do this thing. I understand. For example, I got nobody. Okay, the whole church knew it. There's breaks, three, 4 minutes, stand up, stretch, whatever, take the child to the potty, but then wait until there's applause before you come back in again. Because that this concert is being live streamed, and we don't want all that foot noise on the live stream nor on the recording. So keep your kids with you, please. Other than that, we've got some pictures on our part. We have a prayer, please. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen. Lord Jesus, help us to bring through to fruition the abilities and the talents of these children, their hard work, their young musicians praising your name with their music. Help us to continue to grow in that music. Amen. In the name of the Father, Son, Holy Spirit, amen.
Check, 1, 2. Ah, thank you, Miss. Is this better? A little bit? Okay, thank you, Mr. Lambrick. A little more if we have it, if possible. Thank you, sir. Okay, that was called Who Let the Elves Out? That monitor's on up there, isn't there? That's what I'm hearing. Okay. And there's a feature on Cooking Wenceslas. I do want to introduce somebody right now. You're going to see her all around the different bands tonight, and that is Ms. Danielle Wolf. She, her very first day here, this is a good indication of how nice our kids are. I put her in Mrs. Volkman's homeroom so she could learn how to run a homeroom. And within about the first 30 seconds of her being in the homeroom, one of the kids came up to her and said, "Oh, are you an exchange? And are you a transfer student to Columbus?" She's a senior in college. So Danielle, stand up so they can see who you are, please. Now, your role over the next couple bands is to find out what instrument she plays next. Speaking of next, Akusia Yeboa is featured tenor saxophone solo in How the Grinch Stole Christmas.
Thank you.
This is my 41st year here, and I'm pleased to say that for the first time ever, we actually have a middle. Usually people don't get applauded for being home, but thank you. This is the first time I've ever had a middle school jazz band that meets as a class during the day. It would be twice a week, Tuesdays and Thursdays, coming wonderfully well. I've got great plans for them for the springtime. And we have two. It's hard to find Christmas songs at their age level, so we have two non-Christmas songs. Our first one is
Jumpin' Jelly Beans.
It's a rock tune, and our soloist is Owen Edwards on alto saxophone.
Thank you. Thank you. Next
is, thank you. Next is a swing tune called Darker Shade of Gray. We have two solos, Ben Scherenbach on trumpet and John Feewiger on saxophone. I'd like to point out before we go to our fifth graders. Number one, where's Miss Wolf right now? What instrument is she playing now? She's way in the back playing keyboard bass. Number two, middle school jazz band, raise your hand if you're playing a new instrument that you just started learning either in September or October of this year. So with that thought, middle school jazz band, going to have any instrument. You can see we have a clarinet in here. So what? You've got flutes. So in other words, I'm encouraging parents. We meet Tuesdays and Thursdays, two periods out of the week. If you want your kids in jazz band, I'll gladly take them. Last, we have an arrangement I made up a couple years ago called Jingle Jazz. Three tunes, Jingle Bells, We Three Kings of Orient Are, and We Wish You a Merry Christmas. We have two soloists, and that is Bryce Lang on trumpet and Abby Kimmel on trumpet.
Thank you.
Jack? Okay, fifth grade, go ahead and play for about 30 seconds, please. I'll be right down next to you. Go ahead, fifth grade, you can play. Service to the band, help out the fifth graders at their school. We also had a gentleman, Dakota Hannish, who was helping out the jazz band, playing trombone with it as well. So fifth grade, are we ready? Who's my first reader?
Check one, check two.
Okay, go ahead, it's all your turn.
Good evening, and welcome to our first band concert. We have been working hard and are very excited and a little bit nervous to perform for you tonight. Our portion of the concert is a story about a young boy and how he learned the true meaning of Christmas. Once upon a time, there was a young boy named Trevor. Trevor loved Christmas, loved getting toys, and would always get very excited when Christmas was. Every year, Trevor would try and stay awake so he could see Santa Claus deliver his presents. But every year, Trevor would fall asleep instead. Well, one day, Trevor was very determined to stay awake and catch Santa Claus. He watched out the window for hours and was almost falling asleep when all of a sudden, he heard sleigh bells ring.
Trevor thought he was dreaming, so he wiped the sleep out of his eyes, and sure enough, he heard the sound of jingle bells outside. Up on the roof.
Thank you. started jumping up and down in excitement. "Oh my gosh," he said to himself. "There he is. There is Santa Claus. There is Saint Nicholas."
true meaning of Christmas, that Christmas is about caring about other people and about the baby Jesus being born. Trevor was thinking about the night when Jesus was born and how beautiful it must have been with all the angels singing to Jesus. Especially your parents and your family. We hope you have a very blessed Christmas and a happy, healthy new year. Good night and thank you for listening. Our first concert is now over.
There'll be about a 2 minute, 3 minute delay here. Now's a good time to stand up and stretch if you wish. Jack, you guys can come on up to the front. No, it's fine. Sit with the high school kids. Thank you. Check. Okay, at this point in time, I would like to formally introduce Ms. Wolf, who is student teaching with me this semester. She'll be intern teaching with me next semester, and I'll tell you some other stuff later on. I don't want to make her more nervous than she probably already is. So, Ms. Wolf, do you want the mic first, or I turn it off?
Stomach. Can Santa Can.
What?
Miss Wolf, nice job.
Miss Wolf, nice job. Announcement at this point in time. It was last year on Alpine that I had so many people asking me, are you retired? I think it was out of concern, not to get out the door.
But I
said on the spring concert that announced, I think I've got two more years left on me, and I knew that Danielle Miss Wolf had already been helping out for a summer with organizing and stuff. This was her goal. And I let it go at that.
Probably
around middle of October.
The reason
I bring it up now is because these are the kids who asked. Somebody looked up at me during the rehearsal and said, Mr. Z, do you remember? And I don't know who it was, doesn't matter.
Do you remember when you said that
you're going to retire?
Yes, I do.
And I said, yes, I do.
Well, what's going to happen to us?
What's going to happen to us?
How could I not answer that question?
We already had plans in the works that Danielle would be student teaching this semester, interning next semester, and then next year, and hopefully beyond, we'll be going with two full-time band directors, and she'll be the second director. Thank you, Ms. Wolf.
Wish
to stand and stretch a minute, that's okay. You've got about 3 minutes.
You're working?
He said he'll work. I'm like, okay.
Well, it took me a while to figure out. I don't know as much about Brandon as Brandon does with that.
I'm waiting. You just said it should work fine.
I was able to figure it out. It took me a while.
Yeah, I had no idea.
Or better at than not.
Keen eye, Seth. We need four more chairs, please.
Thank you. this one likes me. Okay. So, as we move on to our 7th and 8th grade portion of the concert, I'd like to take the chance to issue another thanks, this time to you, the parents and audience of this concert. Without you, this would not have been possible, and I'm sure every musician up here appreciates your support. So thank you. Next, we move on to Angels We Have Heard on High, a song that really showcases a lot of the skills that our musicians have worked on this semester, including expressing the music and just showcasing the emotions. So, without further ado, Angels We Have Heard on High.
Thank you. Well done, Miss Wolf. Thank you.
Well done, Miss Wolf. Thank you. And she's not going to join the band on flute, so she's trying to do something different.
Before we do our next piece, this is a piece that one of those pieces,
regardless of age level, always scares me. I played this about three or four times in my 40 some years here, and all three of them okay.
This band is capable of playing the pieces like walking on extremely slippery ice that if you don't focus every single second,
you're going to slip and fall. So if we always count,
especially in our rest,
we should be okay.
It's called Christmas Plain Song, which is a version of
O Come, O Come, Emmanuel.
Well done, 7th and 8th grade. Thank you.
Well done, 7th and 8th grade. Thank you. We'd like to finish up with our version of CanSet, which has a few more difficulties than the 6th grade version. Sorry, 6th grade, we're just a little more mature than you are. As we're getting reset up here, I'll save some time to announce ourselves. Our first song at Christmas Festival is like the original band composition written in the 1940s, I believe. It's got at least 10, 12 different songs in it. Figure it out as you go along how many different songs you hear. Wonderful challenge piece. I'm so old. I played it in high school.
Thank you.
the final piece I'll be conducting for the night, I want to give one last thanks, this time to the students of Columbus. They have been an absolute joy to work with, and I can think of no better group to do my student teaching. Both the ones you see behind me and the ones on the stand have all been exceptionally great to work with and truly a joy. So one more round of applause. Thank you all, truly. Now without further ado, I present the last song I will be conducting tonight, Ding Dong Merrily on High. Thank you.
Thank you. A few last announcements.
Thank you. A few last announcements. Number one, I know the concert is about 15 minutes longer than normal, but that's because of the addition of middle school jazz, which will be key. And I'm thinking time-wise, it's really no longer than coming to a basketball game. We just have one of these a year. Thank you for having an extra 15 minutes in there. Seventh and eighth grade, as always, are responsible for putting away the chairs. The audience.
Okay, so that's your responsibility.
Okay, so high that's your responsibility. Always, high school is always.
We have soul ensemble stuff I got to get to tomorrow,
so if you could make this setup happen, so we don't have to spend time tomorrow setting up whatever you see now, put it back in there, make it happen.
Let me check my notes.
Yeah, I think we're good. So.
As I've been doing for 41 years,
and hopefully this will continue in a couple years, we are going to end with sleigh ride.
Thank you.
Thank you. I neglected to mention the breakfast earlier today. Thank you for your help. We don't have even started a money count up yet, but I'm guessing based on the numbers we had and the food left over, probably around $3,500 we made in those 4 hours. So really quite good. So thank you for helping out. Merry Christmas. See you in the springtime.